Okay, in this tutorial we're gonna learn about enums. Enums, how to say this in English, I don't know. Anyway, this is just hard-coded list and you can choose something from it. Very simple explanation. Practically that means this. Outside, for example, of class main, we are going to have new keyword, enum. See, different color from classical text, just same color as other pieces of Java. At least in Eclipse, this is the color they are using. So, enum, and a little bit of space, and name for that enum. For example, options. Options, and now curly brackets, and bunch of stuff. So you can choose something from it. For example, we are creating some kind of menu in games, audio and video options, and controls for joystick and keyboard. You don't need to use comma for a last element. Okay, so how to use any of these? Well, we need to create object based on options. That's a name of enum. On the right side, we're gonna say like input RBG. Now, on the right side, you cannot say new. We must again target options. And then dot, and then you will have drop down with audio, controls, and videos. Okay, so choose something. Choose, for example, controls. And that's pretty much it. So save and run, and we have something to work with. So how we are going to use this, for example, object? Well, we can use it in a switch block of code, for example, switch, and we will target that input. RBG, and now we need to handle different cases. For example, if end user chooses audio, then we need to do something. System.out.println. This is simplification, but it is easy to understand stuff. For example, audio set in a audio settings. And do you see something missing here? Well, yes, and that's break. Because every time when you choose something, you need to choose something that and nothing else. That's the whole purpose of menu, let's say. So to save a little bit of time, I'm gonna handle also video and also controls. So this is case for video. And of course we must have a break, video settings, video settings and controls, controls and hard-coded string that will be emulation of some big operation, will be like joystick and keyboard or mouse settings. Okay, let me clean this space a little bit. Let's run it. And joystick and keyboard settings, because here we do have controls as a target. You can say that object will be audio, target will be audio, let's say, and corresponding results. Same stuff for video, corresponding results. There you go. Okay. So the question now is how we are going to automatically roll through all these things to have a listing. Okay, let me put this into comments like that. I'm gonna cancel execution and we are going to start with a for each loop. So for on the left side, what are we targeting? Options. So options on the right side, we need to have some RBG and then comma and then again options, options, and then in a drop down when you say dot, you're gonna find values. So let's click on the values. That's how we will extract these things automatically. So we can do something with it, well, automatically. For example, system.out.println, and here we will be that same object. Okay, and run, and there is a listing. Okay, that's it in this tutorial. Thank you for watching. See you next one.